project Blockchain for Hospital using SHA-256 algorithm. This project is developed by using Visual Studio Software with ASP.NET as a front-end, C# as a coding language, and MS SQL Server as a back-end. To open your application, just go to Start and open the Visual Studio Software. So click on the File menu and then choose Open Website and select your project folder and click Open. So now your project is loaded in the framework. The first form of your application is index.aspx. You can find it in the Solution Explorer. You just double click on the index.aspx and it will be loaded here, and just run the project by clicking this play button. So the main objective of this project is to develop a blockchain technology for hospital environment using SHA-256 algorithm. In this project, we are using SHA-256 hash algorithm for transaction and creating hash blocks for each users. So coming to the explanation of blockchain, the blockchain is nothing but a collection of data which is added to other blocks, forming a chain of blocks which can be linked together using hashing. So here we are using SHA-256. So coming to this algorithm, so generally hash is not an encryption. It cannot be decrypted back to the original text, right? So that is, it is one-way cryptographic function and it is a fixed size for any size of source text. So SHA-256 is one of the successor hash function with strongest hash functions available in it. It is used in blockchain to get a constant hash of 266 bits every time. So in this application, we have four major actor that is involved, who are all is admin. Admin is main, and after admin, the four main actors are doctor, junior doctor, nurse, and office staffs. Each actor has a specific feature. So the admin has the rights to create all the actors. The doctor will upload the patient treatment and also forward the treatment to junior doctors. So then the junior doctors, after verifying, forward the treatment to the nurse. So in this part, the hash is generated for every forwards. That is, whenever the treatment is uploaded by the doctor and forwarded to the junior doctor, a hash is generated. That is a previous hash and present hash from doctor to junior doctor. And whenever the junior doctor forwards the treatment to treatment report to nurse, the previous hash and hash will be generated for junior doctor and nurse. So if a junior doctor or a nurse or a office staff made any changes, that is any unwanted changes in the report and sent or forwarded to some other person, that is to nurse or office staff, they will be caught by the admin. So how the admin find whether the report is correct or not is, the admin has the option to evaluate the report and by using this hash generated for the forwards. So we can see that all these options in the demo. So now I am going to log in as an admin first. The username is admin and the password is also admin. So here in this icon, you can using this icon, you can able to see the password and also you can hide the password. So as I said you, the admin has the rights to create all the actors. So here I already created one doctor and two junior doctors. Now I will show you how to create a doctor. So here the doctor ID is the unique, that is, it is the primary key. Doctor ID should not be repeated. So this DOC 001, this ID I have already created. So it is coming as doctor ID exist, and this create button is also get disabled. So now I change the ID as DOC 002. So all the forms are perfectly validated. You can check it here. And I'm going to give the doctor name as Murali. And the department is cancer. And the phone number. Phone number is also validated. See, you can type only 10 digits here. And this is the email ID. And years of experience. And address. So just click on this generate username and password. The system will generate you the username and password. You kindly note here MUR 404 and the password is 530. See, I've already created the junior doctor and I've already noted here nurse office staff. So just click on the create button. You can see the notification doctor created successfully, and the created doctor is also banded in the grid. And there is also an edit and delete option in the grid. If you want to delete a doctor or if you want to edit any other details, you can do here. And if you want to cancel, means you can just click on the cancel. So coming to the nurse part, here I also created a nurse and I also noted a username and password of one nurse. And this is the office staff part. You can create any number of office staffs here. And I also noted the office staff username and password. And patient, I'm going to create a patient now. The patient ID I'm going to give is PAT002, because PAT001 is already available. And the patient name is I'm going to give is Krish, and the department he's going to see is cancer, and the patient age, blood group, and phone number, email ID, address, and the generate username and password. So I'm going to note the patient username and password here. Username and password is 49577. Okay. So now I created all the actors, that is doctor, nurse, office staff, patient, everything. Now I'm going to log in as a doctor. So for login as a doctor, you have to choose the doctor type as user type as doctor and just click on the username and password of the doctor. Username is MUR404 and password is 40530. 40530. Okay. So this is the doctor's master page, and here the doctor has the options like upload treatment, forward history, change password, and logout. And this is the basic detail of the doctor, that is his ID, his department, and then his name. So here you can see the patients we have already created, and this is the treatment ID, which is auto generated by the system, and every time the treatment ID will change. So now I'm going to upload the treatment for patient 2 that we have created already. So I'm going to give the disease details of the treatment. So the disease is cancer, and type and symptoms, coughing, fever, frequent infection, and the medicines prescribed, okay, then remarks. Okay, then discharge details, no discharge. So after entering all the details, you just click on the process summary. So this text box will show you the process summary, that is overall summary that you have typed for the patient 2. And now this doctor, that is this Murali doctor, is going to forward this treatment details to junior doctor, and just click on the junior doctor ID. And if you can also select this icon, click this icon to view the name of the junior doctor and forward treatment. So now the doctor forwarded the treatment to the junior doctor Manohar. Now a hash is generated for the doctor and also for the junior doctor. And in the forward history, you can able to see what are all the treatments you have forwarded and to which junior doctors you have forwarded, and the date and time of your forwards. And this change password is to change the password, that is the password which was generated by the system. You can change here by giving your old password, new password, and retype password. So these are all the options for the doctor. So now I'm going to log in as a junior doctor. So just select junior doctor and note the username and password for junior doctor. So we are going to log in as a junior doctor, and the username I have given, and I'm going to paste the password now. So just log in as a junior doctor. So this is the master page of the junior doctor. Here you can able to see the basic detail of the junior doctor, that is his username, his ID, department, and the name of the junior doctor. So now the junior doctor is going to select the patient ID. And if you also can able to click this icon to view the name, let me show you. Wait. So if you click the icon, means you can able to see the name of the patient, right? Now I'm going to choose patient 2. So a patient 2 can have any number of treatments, right? So currently we have uploaded only one treatment by the doctor. So there is only one ID here. If you are uploading two or one or more treatments, all the IDs will be loaded in this drop down. So I'm going to view this. See, you can view the treatment report that was sent by the doctor to the junior doctor here. So the junior doctor is now going to make a change in this report, and then he's going to forward to the nurse. That is, the junior doctor is going to change the discharge summary, like so I have updated it as discharge in 2 days. And now I'm going to forward this treatment to nurse. So the nurse name is loaded. I'm going to forward the treatment here. So now the treatment is uploaded to the nurse. In the forward history of junior doctor, you can able to see the forward history that he has sent to the nurse, and this is change he has made. And this change is not necessary because the doctor didn't added this change, didn't added discharge summary, but the junior doctor updated the discharge summary without the knowledge of the doctor and sent to the nurse. And this is the change password option of the junior doctor. So now I'm going to log in as a nurse here. So we have already created the nurse, right? Yes. So now we have entered the username and password of the nurse. I'm going to log in as a nurse. And these are the menus for the nurse. And in the view treatment and forward, the nurse can able to view the treatment that was sent by the junior doctor. And this is the treatment which was sent to the nurse by the junior doctor, and the nurse is going to forward this treatment to the staff 2, that is Bob, that we created. Just click on the forward treatment. Now the treatment is uploaded, that is forwarded. In the forward history, the nurse can able to see the treatments forwarded to the staff, and change password. The nurse can change the password which was generated by the system. So now I'm going to log in as office staff. The username is Bob2 and the password is 298. So here in the view treatment details, the staff can choose the patient ID and also the treatment ID, and also can view the treatment details, that is report that he received from the nurse. So now the staff is also going to add few lines, settle the bill before leaving. So this is the line which was entered by the staff unofficially, and now the staff is going to forward this treatment. So just click on the forward treatment button. So the treatment is now uploaded to the patient, and now there is a print option in the staff that you can able to see. So after clicking this icon, you just check whether it is blocked in your browser. If it is so, you just click on the allow and click on done. So now the office staff can save this treatment as a PDF or as a Word, etc. And now I'm going to save as PDF. You just click on the destination and give save. So I'm going to save in the desktop. So now the treatment is now saved. And if you want to print the treatment also, you can also print here. See, you can able to see the preview, right? So you can have more option here. You can choose whatever you want. So now I'm going to show you the forward history of the staff. So this is the forward history, that is the staff sent to the patient by adding a few details in the report, and this is the change password and logout. Now I'm going to log in as an admin. The username is admin and the password is also admin. So here in view transaction, the admin can choose the patient ID, and just the admin can view the transaction. See, you can able to see the hash and the previous hash generated for each forwards, and you can also able to see the time and date of the forwards. And this is the data which was sent by the doctor to the junior doctor and to the nurse and to the office staffs. So now the admin is going to evaluate whether the report which was sent by the doctor reached the office staff without any changes. So just click on the evaluate button. So you can see the blockchain is evaluated and the data modification is done. Yes, the junior doctor to nurse, there is a modification, and then from the office staff to the patient, there is a modification. You can also be able to see the changes here. See, the doctor sent the report to the junior doctor, and the junior doctor added discharge in 2 days. So the nurse forwarded the same report sent by the junior doctor to the staff, but the staff added a line, settled the bill before leaving. So now the admin evaluated these data and founded the changes which was done by junior doctor and office staff, and this is the main part of this application. And let me show you a transaction without changes that I have created previously. So I have already added a patient one and a treatment for patient one. I will show you that. So it's loading the name, and now I'm going to view the treatment. See, this is the patient one treatment which was forwarded and the hash generated, and I'm going to evaluate this. See, the blockchain is evaluated and no modification is done. That is, if the office staff finally received the report which was sent by the doctor without any changes, the system will show you the blockchain is evaluated and no modification is done. And if there is any changes found in between the transactions, the system will evaluate and it will report you there is a changes done and which person had made these changes. And this part is evaluated by using the hash generated during each forwards, and this is the change password part of the admin, and finally this is the logout. And let me show you the patient login. The patient has the rights to view the treatments. So the username is KRI495 and the password is 49577. So view treatment details. See, the patient can view the treatment details, and the patient can also print the treatment details by clicking this button.